Hello everyone, I'm Kai. I'm going to do a tutorial to cover the basics of using Blender. So we're going to make something like this so you can have you can get your basics in modeling with Blender 3D. So I think we're going to use our modeling using spin extrude. We have our modifiers and textures and materials and light setup and world setup with HDRI. So let's get going. Let's open Blender. So that's 57. Okay, there. I'm using Blender 2.68a. I'm just going to turn on my screencast. Yeah. So you will see. So you will see all my. All the keys that I'm using, so let's make it a little bit bigger. Okay. Go. F3. Okay, that's alright. So, as you see here, we have our default cube. So let's go there to front view. This is numpad 1. Then edit mode. So you can go here, edit mode, or just press tab to go to edit mode there. And let's move it up. So press this arrow, click and drag that upward there. Then go to object mode, back again to object mode. So just press tab again to toggle between object mode and edit mode. And then I'm going to pan. So I'm panning using shift and mouse wheel. So let's just make my screencast to be text. Okay, there. So I use pan using shift and up. The shift wheel mouse up. Okay, and press S here. You can also use pan left and right using control and mouse button, and up and down shift mouse button. I shift middle mouse button, the mouse wheel, okay. And mouse wheel. So there we have a nice big box. This default wheel is going to be our stage. So let's press that. Press click this and shift right click this. So right click is the selection in Blender. So to select two edge, we're going to select this edge. Click and shift right click. Press X to bring the delete menu and vertices. Yeah, so we're left with two face. So let's move this one a little bit forward. So there, make sure you're seeing the arrow. So this, the blue one is pointing. The blue one is for Z axis. The green one's Y axis, and the red one for X axis. So let's move it on the X axis to make a nice big stage. And then go to side view, F3, and extrude. No. Here, extrude E to extrude, and then right click to snap the extrusion, and click this yellow, this blue icon down. Well, let's find the blue. Rotate. And so let's make this one a little bit fatter on the X axis. So click this. Click this widget for the size, and click this red, drag this red handle there. Okay, so we have our nice big stage. Now let's create. I'll move it a little bit back. Yeah. So to change the view, as I'm doing, you just need to click the middle mouse button and drag around. So there. See, we're going to add some loop cuts. So to add loop cuts, press Ctrl R there, and then click and slide to where you want the loop cut be, and then click again. So Ctrl R, click and slide, and click again. Ctrl R, click and slide, and click again. No, Ctrl R, click it, slide it to where you want it to be, and click. Ctrl R, click and slide where you want it to be, click. Then controller again, click we want it to be, and slide. Okay, then I think it's nice. Let's press this on your tool shelf here. Press move, and then go to the properties window here. Click this if you are not seeing the wrench icon. So we're going to add a modifier there. Click this wrench icon, it's a modifier. Let's add a modifier, subdivision surface. So you see the reason we add loop cuts there so that we can have this nice curve here instead of a very big curve without the loop cut. So if you just add the subsurface, it will deform badly. So let's see there. Let's name this one as floor. Floor. And let's name it here. Floor. So just copy the name. To copy, it's just Control C. To copy the name. Now we have our stage. Let's go to front view and orthographic, front ortho. Go to the next layer. So we just click it here to go to the next layer. We're going to create the saucer or the plate. So let's add the new mesh, shift A, plane, add a plane. So shift A is to bring the add menu and then add a plane. Align it to view. Okay, there. Align it to view and go to edit mode. Tab. So let's delete all these three vertices here. So press X, select them. So click, shift right click, and then press X to bring the delete menu and choose vertices. So we're done with vertices. Now make sure that the cursor is in the middle or in the center. We're going to use this axis line to as a point of reference. So shift S to make sure that it fits in this or in different size. So you need press shift S to snap it, cursor to center. And then right click this single vertices that we left and shift S, we're going to snap that to where the cursor is. So selection to cursor. So there. So we're going to be the middle point of our plate. So now let's draw the plate. You just press E to extrude and drag it. So make sure you're in front ortho to do this. So drag it and press G if you want to move it a little bit more. Press E if I move it freely. So let's move it like this. You're just going to draw the outline of the plate or the saucer. Extrude. Extrude E. So based on the outlines, where you see how the saucer will look like. There. And right click this, I'm just going to arrange it. So you can make your own design, the saucer, if you want, whatever you, how you like it to look like. And then I think I will make it like that. There. Then after you have it, after you have the outline, if you're satisfied with it, we'll be going to let's move this one there. Okay, let's, if you're fine with the outline, let's go to top view, then press A to select it all, and then in your tool shelf here, press pin. There we have their 90. By default it's 90 degrees. Let's make it 360 to make a circle. 360. And let's make the step to 16. Usually use 16. Okay, there. And click A to deselect that and A again. Let's bring the specials menu and W and remove doubles. The reason why we need to remove the doubles because here you see this part where the beginning and the end meet. It's actually not closed, so to close that we need to remove the doubles. Okay, there we have our plate. Does it look good? Let's go to font size. So that's how our saucer looks. Let's make the shading in here. So we're in object mode, so make the shading smooth from the tool shelf and go to modify again the wrench icon. Add a subdivision surface modifier. As you see, we're using subdivision surface modifier a lot. So there, so it looks much better. A nice plate there. Created. Let's name this saucer. Okay. Make sure to name your objects. Oh, name it saucer there. And let's move it. Let's select the first layer. So shift and click there. And let's see how it looks. Okay, it looks good there. It looks good there. I think the size is nice for it. Let's go to front view and see how it relates with the with our stage. So I think we need to move our stage a little down there. So make sure it's touching that, but we're barely touching it there, but not that it's so not that. Let's just move this. I think that's in a nice place now. I think that's good. Make sure that it's not floating, okay? That this one is not floating. There, you see that it's just barely touching the floor. So make sure that's not floating. So we have it, the saucer. Now let's create the mug. Let's do the mug. So go to the third one. Go to front view. Let's insert another plane. Shift A and plane. There. Align it to view. And then make sure that you delete it. Make sure that your cursor in the center. It and press S and vertices, and then let's make sure the cursor is in the center. Shift S, cursor to center, then click this one and snap it to the cursor. Shift S, selection to cursor, and let's make the outline of the mug. I think I'm going to have a mug. It looks like how would I want my mug to look? Something like this. So extrude and shape the mug accordingly to what you want it to shape. So I want something like a very curvy mug. Something like this. So I'm going to make, so this is the spin modeling using spin is not the only way to model a mug. So I'm showing you how to model another one using the extruding from circle. So let's just extrude and move it until you create the outline. So it's pretty easy, and I think that's fine. Let's select these two vertices to form an edge and subdivide that to add another two and subdivide that so we can have a nice bottom here. Okay, let's select it all and go to tap view, and then let's spin. As you see, it saved the last pin we have. So, select all and then bring the specials menu and W and remove the box. Yeah. So, we close that and we have something that looks like this. So, it's not good. Let's put a smooth and there and add another subdivision surface to it. Oh, you see there that we have something like this. Then, you have something like that since it's caused by a subdivide. You just need to go to edit mode, select it all, and then in your tool shell, find the recalculate there. So it will be back to normal. I think we have some nice thing. So let's go to top view, edit mode again. Let's make these two sides face the X axis. So press R to rotate. There, R, rotate there. So it's on the side. Then go to side view, edit mode again. Going to add a loop cut here and pull. I think we're just going to pull it here. pull the arm, the handle there. So let's click Control R to do cut, slide it here or to where you want it and click. So there. Okay, select those. And I think we're not going to attach, I'm not going to attach mine, but if you want to attach it in your mug, you can have another loop cut here or here, and then loop it and join them here. But me, I'm going to do something with a little flare like around this. Okay, so select that. Now, press S to make it a little bit better. Do that. So if you want, here. Then press E to extrude. Here, just a little. Okay, just a little, and then R. So you can have a little smaller. And I think it's okay. Extrude again. There, you can make it face a little bit upward with it. So we're going to just shape up the. Okay, I'm going to undo. Undo is just Control Z. R. Extrude. There, R, rotate and move a little, extrude, G, R, move a little, R, so you just need to adjust to how you want it to look like. So I'm go to there, in wireframe mode, I select this because I don't like how they position. There, go to wireframe mode and press C to use circle select, there, and back to solid view. So you can use the wireframe view to sell to make sure that the vertices on the back will get selected when you circle select, especially if you're in front or side view. Extrude G, rotate, extrude G, rotate, extrude G, and rotate and move a little, then extrude G, rotate. Okay, extrude, move a little, rotate, extrude, move a little, and rotate, so move is G, so extrude, G, grab, to move, and R to rotate, extrude, G, grab, move, and R to rotate, and let's make it a little smaller, press this, the size handle, or widget, and there, to make it back. So we have a nice handle. I think we've done a decent handle there. You can make it go up or big, whatever you want. So I think I'm going to adjust that. So I go to wireframe mode and we'll adjust this a little there. So I'll just see to select that and you can adjust. So that you can adjust some of the parts right there. So I think, yeah, there. We have a nice handle. So go to front view. I select this layer, shift, right click, shift, click. Let's see how it goes relative to the saucer. So I think that's about the right size. If it's not the right size, if you want to size it, just press S to make it bigger or S to make it smaller. So I think I'll make it a little bigger. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And just make sure that it's barely touching there. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So I think that's about enough for the saucer. Zero. To see how it looks in the camera. So press Control S. Now I'm going to save it at this point. Control S. And then I'm just going to upgrade one of my previous. Yeah. So make sure to save, okay? So that when you crash, you can recover it. But well, Blender have an auto recover that it saves for every like. 5 minutes. Let's see here. Mm-hmm. I think now we're going to, for the third one, we're going to make the glass. Oh, I forgot. Let's name this one cup. Cup. Okay, see, and cup. Yeah. Let's go to the fourth layer. Make sure again that your cursor is in the middle. So shift A and add a circle. We're going to create a glass from extrude. So vertices, make it to 16, and you only use 16. I think that's adequate. Then fill type 2 and gone. Yeah. So it will have some fill. Okay, then go to edit mode. We're not going to align it to view. Let's just make it point upward. So go to edit mode tab. And let's press E to extrude. There. So I'm going to shape it up a little. So S to shape it up. And then E, extrude again. Okay, then E, extrude up, something like around this. And press S to make it a little bit bigger. E, extrude up, and S. To the layer like that. So I think that's about enough. So we're going to do the ring. Press D, so we can see inside. So E, extrude, S, to make it size a little. E, extrude, and E, extrude, right click to snap out of the extrude. And then press this one to move it inside. There. Press S to size it down. So let's move it there. So E, extrude again, and there, around this side, right in here. And press S, E, extrude, and go here, around here, and S, to size it down. Then E, extrude, there, a little bit size down, extrude again, and size down again. So creating a little size down there. And S, there. Now we created the glass there. We're also doing another thing, so press 1 again. Go to edit mode. Press Z again. And let's use another selection type. So we have used the circle selection C. We're going to use the bounding box selection, which is B. So there you see it. And let's select this one. And go to a little bit in a different angle there. Press E. So let's go to object solid view. Press E. And S, there, E, and S. Then go to front view, and let's move that a little bit up. Let's see, can you see? Yeah. So press move. There, we're going to add modifier, subdivision, surface, there. Looks nice, but we'll have some problem here, so let's go to edit mode again. Press Control R, so instead of click and slide, we're going to add about 3 loop cuts or 2 loop cuts. So in this tab, we're going to add 2 loop cuts. Just scroll up there. And here, Control R and scroll up. Do the same on the inside here, Control R. So make sure that it's in the inside. Scroll up and click. And double click again to make it stick. Control R. Open and click and click. Yeah. So I think we have a nice before. Okay, I think we have a nice deform there. And let's name that glass. Let's see. You can make your mug out of just extruding, since there are mugs that are straight. Or with a little flare, just like that. So let's see, shift S. And yes, so just shift select all of these layer and see how the mug go, how or the glass goes. So it's big, so much bigger than the other. So just press S to scale it down to a size that you like around this, and make sure that it's barely touching. Okay, let's move it a little down. Yeah, no, I think that's enough. It's barely touching the floor, but it's not floating. Okay, let's change our camera angle to something about here. There. Control up. So if you want to change the camera angle into, for example, you rotate and you think, oh, this is a good angle. You just press Control up 0 to move the camera there. So like that. Okay. So let's move this stage to a little bit to the right. So there. So it will not be showing in cut. And let's make it move up. There, I think that's enough for that. So we have the glass and the mug. So let's try to do. Okay. move it. Let's move it here. So let's do our, let's do some arranging. So let's move it a little bit there. So let's do some arranging here. So F7, if you want to rotate this a little like this, or make it a little bigger. Okay. Here we have the glass here. I think we'll move it. And let's move. So shift select, we want to select two objects. Shift right click just to select two objects so we can have it. Yeah. Let's see, is that good? Let's make it a little like this. And change the camera to that angle. I think that's fine. No. Okay. Let's go to the flip. And let's create another object. So our cursor is not in the center, so shift S, cursor to center, and let's add an plane. Shift A, plane. So this time we're going to model something using extrude. So we're going to extrude this. So now go to top view. There we have our plane and edit mode, and then in your tool shell find subdivide. There, subdivide. So we'll have this two. Nice one. Some more vertices there. And select this three. You can use circle select, select them. And to add the reduce or decrease the reduce circle, use the middle mouse button. So we're going to size it down, press S. There. And go move. So let's shape. Let's make a shape of the head. Okay, here. The shape of the head. There. So press extrude. Here. And shape up. Extrude. And shape up. There. You have the shape of it. And let's go to front view. Now let's go to front view and shape, so this spoon shape something like this. Okay, so let's shape our spoon like that. Extrude. There, I think I overdid here. Okay, let's select those, this free one. Okay, then go to front view again. Oh, there, let's just end this step. Then here, we're going to make the concave. We'll make this to concave a little, so press control. We're going to add some loop cuts here, control R. And another one here, control R again. And just double click. Let's press, select this three in the middle, go to front view, and using the handle, okay, there, then select the one in the middle, and there. So we have it, select this one as well, and move it a little bit down, okay, then so create the concave. Okay, that's fine now. Now select this stuff here, I'm going to move that up, there. And the other side, F1 again, and move it up, and this one to move up like that. So this one. So I think we have our concave. We also have need to move this a little, this side a little there. And let's move. Let's press J to go to wireframe mode. So we're just going to use the circle select and get the opposite vertices selected. So let's move that down to around that. So I'm just trying to make this level there. Okay, there. But as you see, it looks like paper. So let's add smooth there. And of course, we're going to add our subdivision surface. But it still looks like paper, right? So let's go to edit mode. And let's change the shape a little. We're going to adjust the shape. There. There. To make it look more like a spoon. And it's going to change the shape here. So we have there, and this a little like that, and this a little. Okay, so let's make there, and let's make a much better there. So there, but it still look like paper, so we're going to add solidify modifier. So solidify will add some layer like that. Let's go to front view and you see that it's sticking. So it's sticking, so this one sticking. It's getting fit, so that's around point. So let's make it around there. Just click until you find out there. Around 0.530, so I think that's fine. If you go up here, I think that's fine, and then so. But we need to make the solidify modifier on top of the subsort. So to do that, just click this button so that the solidify will be on top of the subsort. So it will add the solidify modifier before the subsort. Right there. I think we have some nice spoon there. So let's go to select this, the one we have. So our spoon is quite bigger than the other. So let's press S there and move it around S there. So now we're going to this our point of origin. We're going to make that here into the top. So let's select, go to edit mode, select these two, then shift S cursor to. Select that to move the cursor there, and then go to object mode and in the tool shell, click origin and origin to 3D cursor to transfer that. So it will make our rotation a little much more easier. So let's move it there and here. Okay, and let's rotate it. Press R to rotate it around 180 degree, and then go to tab and rotate again there. Then G to move it around, it will move it here, and R there, and press 1. So let's press middle mouse button to move it at an appropriate angle, and then R to, oh, so you see how that works. So let's just move it R, and just make sure that it's barely touching it. So, I think that's fine. Okay, so we have our spoon there, cup. Okay, so we're only missing the one with the multiple. So we're going to do that later. So there we have our cup. So the mug is not seen. So if I want to see the mug, just click this. Just click this widget, this manipulator, and click this blue one on there so we can see. Now let's name this our spoon. Let's name it spoon. Of course, let's name it spoon. Spoon. And the other one is this spoon. And save it. For now, let's add. So now we're ready to add materials. Usually, add materials after I created the object. But now, so I can show you, we're going to add materials now. So let's start with the cup. So the cup, we're going to use something like with gloss. It's very glossy, so let's add a material. To add material, you see there, you just click the add new. So let's repeat that right there. Just click this add new plans new there. You have the materials. Let's rename it like ceramic cup. There we have the ceramic cup material seen, but we want something glossy, so we're going to check the mirror. So here in mirror tab, check that. Then change the reflectivity to around, it's up to you, but I usually 0.1, 0.2, 0.3. Just a slight reflect, I think that will do. Okay. And then here, since I don't want it to become like plastic, I usually move the specular to 0. So, sorry for that. That's just my brother. Okay, let's go back. So there we have our ceramic cloth, our first material. So now let's go to transfer that. So we have our plate. So I want it to have a the same kind of glossy material that is in the cup. So to do that, you just need to click here in this button. So we're in material stuff. So it's the red globe. If you haven't noticed yet, it's the red globe. So we're here in the red globe here, and just put there ceramic cup. There. So we have use one, the same material from the cup, and here. So if you change the color of that, it will change the color of the cup. But I want it to be white as well. So they're sharing the same material. Now I want this one to have have a different color to the side. This one. So for other design. So I'm going to enter edit mode, and we're going to have a new material slot here for that. So enter edit mode and then select this edge. So the edge, and then in select menu, click edge loop there. Then control plus there. So we have control plus. So we're also going to select this one later. Then click this add button here, this plus button in the side plus, to create a new material slot, and then press assign there. So we assign that place to that. So let's add another one. So we have clicked that. Yeah, then we have assigned it, but still doesn't have a material. So we're going to use same material as a ceramic cup, but different color. So we just use ceramic cup, so it's the same. But then if we change that, obviously everything will change, the cup and the saucer will change. So we're just going to derive a material from ceramic cup. Now I think it's supposed to be there. We're going to derive a material from ceramic cup. So click that second material, and then press this plus here. This plus beside here, this plus, select that. So we have ceramic material cup one. So it's a derived color. So let's, for example, I have a pink color there, pink or violet, but then whatever color you have, blue, green, whatever color you want there. So then we just change each color, for example, there. Okay, so if you see, that's what happened. So I'm going to add another loop. So to add another loop there. So just select this to edge again, then edge loop, and then control plus. So control plus, it expands the selection to a one more ring. So just expand selection. So there. So let's see. I want to have one here, this side. This side I want it to have the same color. So I'm going to press C and deselect. Okay. So I'm going to there. So it's two layer there, and then I'm just going to assign it aside. So, see, I think that looks fine. We have one in the center there. We have our saucer, and now for the spoon, we're going to add something for the spoon. Let's just click add. It does not have a material. Click add new. And for the spoon, I think we're going to be the metal look. So, so something like a dark gray. Just slide it down there to make it darker. So I'm going to work with the small intensity of spectra, but not totally devoid of it. I'm going to change this word ISO. You can do with foam. Also, no, I'm going to use foam. Foam or word ISO, whatever spectra. So they have different way for the shader. So let's check mirror. So since metal have reflection, so I'm going to do 0.2. And I'm going to decrease the gloss, since I think spoons or the stainless doesn't reflect that much, so it has some kind of roughness. Gloss there, and go to the texture samples to 100. I think that will work now, but this change, adding the samples will increase the render time. Okay, I'm going to make it a little bit lighter. I think that will be fine. So, let's for the spoon. And let's have the glass. Oh, let's rename the spoon material to something that no, so it's metal. That makes sense. Right? Oh, there's something like that. Let's I'm just rotating my spoon. I'm just arranging the spoons. Yeah. I think that's enough. Okay. So I'm just try to arrange them. So now we have, let's go to the glass. What's in it? Object mode? Oh, I think. Okay. Let's select the glass and add a new material. Then just add new. And we're going to do with the glass. So for this, we're going to make it white, light, and some tinge of blue there, a small tinge of blue. And we're going to check transparency and do to ray trace and make the alpha to 0 there. But you see, it's like it almost gone. So IOR, we make the IOR index of refraction to around 1.6. Glass is 1.4 to 1.6. Okay, so let's make our Fresnel around 1. Okay. And the blending to 1.5. I'm just changing this. You can experiment with that. And let's add mirror. There, mirror reflectivity around 0.5. There, or 0.2. So I think that's fine for the glass. Okay, I think that's fine. So ray trace, we're going to transparency ray trace instead of the transparency. Okay, so again, that adds to your render time. So, okay. I think we have one we're going to add now. We're going to add that stack up plates in the back. So, to add that, we're going to duplicate this plate. So, go to top view. Alright, let's move this out. So, go to top view, select this, right click, select that, and Shift T, and move that around the back. Move. So, we have a duplicate of the saucer. So now, we would want to stack it upwards. We're going to the range or the modifier icon, the modifier. Add a new modifier, which we will be calling array. So you see, we have two more plates, but we want it to be stacked above each other. So let's go to play this to normal, since it's following normal relativity. So as you see, it's the green, so which means that the green, so I said earlier, that's the y-axis. It's the y-axis of this. The y-axis of this mesh. So we're going to have the relative offset. So this is x, y, z. So we're going to make the x 0 and the y 1. But it's too much up to one another. So we're just going to decrease it until they look like they are on top of one another. So like that. So let's go to and see. I think they are on top of one another. That's that. And you just need to add more plates. You just need to increase that. There, we have more plates. So I think that's about it. Let's change our ink into something else. So I'm going. So I'm just changing the place. No, don't like that. Something like this. Control F and 0. I'm just trying to find a much better camera angle. So I think this will do. There. So let's have this floor, our stage. And we're going to add materials to it as well. So go to the red ball icon, which is the material. So I want it to have a little bit mirror, so around just 0.050 will do. And we're going to add texture. So to add texture, you go here, In the checkered box, in the checkered plane, near the ball icon, the red ball icons are there. We have, by default, it have textures. This is the default material. So if ever it does not have, it will look something like this. We just click new there. And add here, the clouds, we have the image or movie. And then let's name the texture wood floor. Since I'm going to use a wood floor. So you can have texture from the internet or texture hosting site, whatever. But I have one here, I think. A wood floor, I have one ready there. So you can have that. And then from texture, let's make it bold so you can see how it will look in your material there. So let's go down. You have your image in mapping, the mapping tab, make it cube. Since you have your this one, you have this case here to make it cube, and then click to normal. So let's go to add like 0.050. I usually start very low unless you want it to become bumpy, but we're just going to add some small bumpiness there. Okay, like that. So go to object mode, so we have our material like that, but I'm going to decrease the specular of the floor. Decrease. So we have decreased the specular, so it's not too shiny. So I think that's enough for the floor. We have here, here, and here. But if we render that now, so I'm going to render it, you will see that it's not good since we're missing another one. So all the materials are good, but if we render that, so I'm going to pause this and we'll see the render later. Okay, it's rendered. So I'm just rendering at 25 for preview. As you see, it may, the materials may look nice, but the scene we created does not look nice because we still missing light setup. So we'll go to do light setup. Go away from this. You just need to press escape to go back. There, we have escape to go back, and let's save that. So we're going to do the light setup. So get rid of that point light there. Okay, there, and we're going to make, I'm going to make a 3-point light setup. So my key light will be here. Actually, make the key light on the opposite side of the camera. So if my camera is here, my key light is here. If my camera is here, my key light is here. So usually, so but there are very different kind of light setup. So I'm going to make my key light there. So go to side view. So let's put it here, slightly above there, and Shift A, and add a lamp. We're going to use area. So area actually makes, it's one of the lamp that is, that takes long to render, but it's good. A skin light, so there. Okay, on go to the light setup there and press area. We have area, then we have ray shadow. Click ray shadow. Then we're going to have, instead of, you see there the black shadow. Oh, I hate that, too sharp. I think that's too sharp, so I make the shadow to gray, and then sampling to it. So sampling again that will make your render longer, but that makes it more, that makes it good. And then we have here the distance. The distance is this line. So if it's too long, it will be too bright. So we just make the distance around 10 there. So let's rotate it R. So there, I think we need to decrease the distance again. So I think 7 there. So just make the distance around barely passing through the where your objects are. Okay, so I'm going to make the square shape around 3, so it will be big. So that's your area lamp. It's the IOK lamp. It's a little big. It's the main source of your light there. It's the main source of the light. So there, then rotate it to the. Now we're going to add a fill light. So we're making a 3-point light setup. So this is just 3 lights. So I'm going to have a fill light here and a backlight here. So we're going to add a fill light. So Shift A, add a lamp. So a good fill light will be a hemi. Oh, for this the key light, you can also use pot lamp if you want with some hollow, which have different setup. You can use that. So I'm going to add my fill light here. So fill light is used so that, so I'm going to go this back to global. So fill light is used so that you don't have darker area, and usually they are about just right, but have a very low energy, so they're very dark. Okay, there. So I'm going to have a tinge orange. It's good to have it a slight tinge. There. Same with that. So there, 0.1. I think that's fine. And then let's duplicate this Shift D to add for the backlight. So you can have the backlight a little bit more brighter if you want. So usually if the light is far from the camera, you can make it brighter. Or you can make it dimmer. So the backlight there, to avoid the dark value, there's also fill light here. So I think that's good for our lightning setup. Let's try to render it. Okay, I'm going to pause this again. Okay, there, it's finished rendering. It took around 2 minutes to render at 25%. So you see here some noise. If you want to get rid of that, you need to decrease the sample size in the area. So I think it looks good, but we need to add some more reflections. See there. So the last part of this tutorial, we're just going to add an HDR image to our. We're just going to add an HDR image to the world. So click this blue globe here, which is the globe, the world, the blue globe, and then click the texture, this checkered icon. There, press V and image or movie. There, so in image, open an HDRI image, an HDRI. So you can find them in different websites. You can choose one. So I have different one. If you have an HDRI that looks like this, you need to set up the view to angular map. But I don't think I'll be using that one. I think I'll be using this one. In Cycles it will be mirror more, but here I think it's angular view. So let's see. Let's have that. Let's open the image and let's go to both, and you see that this is your world, this is the texture, and it's not affecting it. So we're going to change some more settings. So we have the image here in mapping, let's view to unmap, but still not. And here uncheck blend and check horizon there. So if you see global, there's its global, you can use that as well, I think. There's angular map here. There you can use that. To different object. Then let's use angular. There. And so this in the world, so why it is horizon, because it's the one that is affecting you can just blend, so you can just blend, but by default it's the horizon. So just go back to here, and I think we're ready to render that. So you have your HDRI and it's the last phase. That's it. Press F12 to render. We're going to render in 25% again. You just see the preview, so press F12 to render. And I'm going to pause this again. Okay, there, it takes another 2 minutes, or around 3 minutes to finish, but so you see the effect of the HDR, right? The reflection of the window and stuff. Okay, so now I think we're ready to render this at full 100%. So you just need to crop it at 100 and render. But I'm going to end my tutorial here. So I hope you get to use Blender more. Use your Blender, and I hope you learned all the basic workflow in Blender, how to model, add texture, and stuff. And well, if you're a beginning Blender, try to make a scene like this. I'm look forward to that. And if you have question, leave it in the comment below. Or if you have clarification, leave it in there, or just ask me, or go to blenderartist.org. So yeah.